May we all rise in honor of the bread. Special day in joining Casey and Sean in the union of marriage. And who gives this bride to be this afternoon?
I do.
Thank you, sir. Sean, you may now receive your bride. You may all be seated. Thank you. Now, Casey, Sean, you both had your own path. You both had your own life experiences that brought you to this very moment. And that's what the unity candle later on will represent. Your individual lives today becoming one in marriage. And in marriage, through that journey, there's a few things that I could leave with you. It would be from the heart to have the ability to listen, learn, and love. Listen to the other, what they have to offer, their wants, their needs, their desires, their dreams, their goals. Secondly, learn what it takes to help them, if not yourself, help them fulfill those wants, needs, desires, hopes, dreams, and goals. And lastly, and I say lastly, love unconditionally. Because you could love somebody, but unless you're willing to listen and to learn, then there isn't much to gain. Now it's going to take the commitment and the love and devotion from both of you to this marriage to make it work. But with the two of you together, with those promises in mind, your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So with that said, I'll ask you first, Sean, by your presence here today, inside of Casey, do you take her as your wife in promising to love, honor, cherish, and to respect her, allowing nothing or no one to come between the both of you? Do you take her as your wife?
I do.
Casey, I'll ask you the same. By your presence here today, on the side of Sean, do you take him as your husband in promising to love, honor, cherish, and support him, allowing nothing or no one to come between the both of you? Do you take him as your husband?
I do.
If I could have you take your bouquet, please. And if you would please turn and face each other and take each other's hands. Now, looking into each other's eyes, you should see the very reason why you are here today, showing that no one is more important than who stands before you. Now, Sean, looking into her eyes, if you could please repeat after me. I, Sean, take you, Casey.
I, Sean, take you, Casey.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I will stand beside you.
I will stand beside you.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
In victory or defeat.
Victory and defeat.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
I understand you have some vows you'd like to exchange yourself. So at this time, if you could just please express them to me.
We met in the craziest of places. A place where people fight on a daily basis. Fight to survive, fight to raise their children, and fight to gain land and freedom. Through the midst of it all, I found my soulmate. I found a woman with so much love and compassion in her heart. Since we have been together, you have given me something so priceless that it's hard to describe. The best way to describe it would be to call it your unconditional love. With you, there are no barriers. There is no holding back, no halfway measures. Our love has honesty, tenderness, and total unquestioning trust. With you, I feel I can open up and be a much better man. When my son Sean was born, I realized what a miracle was. When I helped deliver Kennedy, I realized that God had given me two of the greatest miracles.
Dan, I want to say thank you for allowing me to marry your daughter. I promise to take care of your miracle.
In Psalms 14 in the Bible, it says, love is good, love is kind, it does not boast, it does not judge, love does not question itself, love is never jealous or resentful. That is the love I have for you. You truly are my angel. I promise to love you unconditionally with every bit of my heart. I promise to honor you as the woman beside me. I promise to be faithful and cherish you with every breath that I breathe. I will sacrifice with you and for you to make our love last for the rest of our lives. Please know, when I place this ring on your finger, you have my heart, my soul, and my unconditional love.
Casey, I'm looking into his eyes. If you could please repeat after me. I, Casey, take you, Sean.
I, Casey, take you, Sean.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I will stand beside you.
I will stand beside you.
Through success or misfortune.
Through success or misfortune.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
In victory or defeat.
In victory or defeat.
I will love and respect you.
I will love and respect you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
At this time, can you recite your own vows that you have?
You have been everything that I've ever asked in another human being. You love me without question or worry. You're my best friend and my soulmate. You have taught me that life is not always perfect, but anything is possible if we do it together. I have a smile on my face every day that you're in my life. Today we become more than best friends or soulmates. No word can ever describe how happy and thankful I am to become your wife. I love you with all of my heart. The night you knocked on my door overseas and said that you had to go, my heart sank at the thought that you were walking away without hearing me tell you I love you. Since then, I have reminded you every chance I could that you mean the world to me, that you've given me everything I've ever asked for. I promise I will always be your best friend. I will always listen to you, and we will always be together.
It's a beautiful vows you guys expressed. Knowing that a lot of those were a feeling of blessings, commitments. And although no marriage can be perfect, you both found someone perfect for you. And at this time, may I have the rings, please? Okay. Now these rings not only sealing this commitment, they are symbols of your love and devotion, tokens of them. And my hope is that every day in wearing these rings, may they remind you of the promise and the pledge that you are making to one another. And in time, the rings will fade in value and in beauty. But I hope that you take honor in wearing the rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both. So Shauna, taking her rings first, if you could please place it upon her ring finger and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
And I feel so honored.
I feel so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
Casey taking Sean's token. If you could place it upon his ring finger and repeat, with this ring,
If this ring,
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
And I feel so honored.
And I feel so honored.
To call you my husband.
To call you my husband.
Now at this time, if I could have you guys step over to the unity candle. And as I mentioned earlier, both of you had your own separate paths here, your both individual lives with your experiences that made you, Sean, the man that you are here today. And for you, Casey, the woman that you are here. But in the pledges and the promises you're making to one another in marriage, your two individual lives will now be joined into one life in marriage. At this time, may I have you take a hold of your individual tapers and light the center candle at the same time. Signifying that not only creating a new life together, it will join a new journey with new memories. I would invite you back to the front of the podium, where at this time may she have her bouquet. Now, if you love somebody, you'll be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You'll believe in them, you'll expect the best of them, and you'll stand your ground in defending them, no matter what. And there's a saying that I like to leave with you too. And it goes, don't walk in front of me, I may not follow. Don't walk behind me, I may not lead. But walk beside me, as a friend. Because after all, that is what you're building. A deeper, stronger, richer friendship built upon the relationship that you already have. So in the presence of friends and family as witnesses, by the exchanging of your rings and the exchanging of your vows, you have showed your intent by being here, and with authority vested in me by the state of Nevada. The 30th of August, a day that will now mark your anniversary. Sean, Casey, you are now husband and wife. Sean, you may now kiss your wife, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Lopez. Congratulations, you two.